I am a former follower of Jonathan Kleck. I have joined with other former followers of Kleck's ministry and enlisted professionals. We have spent many hours examining why we followed Kleck away from the gospel of Jesus Christ and into the Neverland of Strong's Concordance doctrine. Who we are is not important. What we have learned is, these are the beginnings of our findings. Jonathan Kleck is teaching a false doctrine. Why? Part 3. Sleight of hand and author of confusion. It is a well-known fact that religious and cult leaders utilize trance-state access of their followers. As humans, we naturally go in and out of a trance multiple times a day. A skilled influencer utilizes, intentionally or not, their ability to access the trance state of listeners. It is a skill developed through the use of many techniques. Voice command, induction of emotion, hand gestures, storytelling, just to name a few. Anyone who thinks hypnosis is harmless might do well to remember that Hitler studied it after being cured by a hypnotist of the hysterical blindness that he suffered at the end of the First World War. His personality changed at that point as the result of a strong suggestion given in a trance by a psychologist who told him that he was special and that he had great personal powers, and that with these great powers, he could cure himself of the blindness. This acted as a post-hypnotic suggestion, and Hitler went on to induce receptive trance states in vast crowds at rallies, bombarding them with emotionally arousing nominalizations. These are some examples of a skilled influencer practicing his art.
And when he had opened the book, look at this. In the sense of reversal, please.
Notice the hand gestures here.
What just got delivered to you right here? I mean,
now listen to the tone of voice.
Reversal. Understand what just got delivered to you right here.
Hand gestures and tone of voice are used to induce trance in the listener.
I mean, do you understand? In the sense of reversal. In the sense of reversal. In the sense of reversal.
How conversational hypnosis works. The Milton model. Conversational hypnosis is very flexible, so hypnotists often put their own spin on it. This model is about inviting the listener into the trance rather than pushing it on them. It affords the listener the opportunity to enter a hypnotic state with their eyes wide open. The Milton model has four foundational steps. Step 1. Distract the conscious mind. The first step of indirect hypnosis is to engage the conscious mind. A conversational hypnotist can do this in multiple ways. Most often, they use a story. Other times, They confuse the conscious mind or distract it with diversion techniques. Step 2. Free the unconscious mind of the critical faculty. This is the part of your mind that separates what is true or useful from what is imaginary or irrelevant. If the critical faculty is still fully active, your mind won't engage with the story's underlying moral. If the critical faculty is not out of the way, the mind may ignore the symbolism, which will diminish the impact of the hypnosis. Step 3. Engage the unconscious mind. The speaker engages with the unconscious mind and speaks directly to the listener's thoughts that drive action. When those thoughts are addressed, powerful changes can be made. Step 4. Communicate with the unconscious mind. Speaking to the listener's unconscious mind, the framework to solve the problem is delivered. This is where the actual message, the moral of the story, for the unconscious mind is deposited. Once the listener's unconscious hears the moral, it maps out a solution. What you are going to hear next is a culmination of these 4 steps that leads your unconscious mind to take in the new information that Jonathan Kleck wants you to believe.
When he opens the book to you, when you understand the Bible, it's the same thing. That's what it was for me. 100% nylon doesn't make any sense. Jonathan, turn it upside down. 100% no line. Then the truth was revealed to me. 100% no line. Then the truth. 100% no line. Then the truth. 100% no line. Then the truth was revealed to me.
The next video snippet is 4 minutes long. It is a very small portion of a typical Jonathan Kleck video. In it, you will see how he weaves all 4 of the steps of the Milton model throughout his narrative. Here, he begins by distracting the conscious mind.
Coming out from under the Virgin? Well, where's that picture of the locust guy I just showed you? It's from the Vatican, and they worship the Virgin. So they have the same common denominator, the Virgin. And look, here's another red skateboard right here. And I'll enlarge it real quick, just so you can see I'm not lying. This is absolutely what's going on.
Next, he works on freeing the unconscious mind of its critical faculty.
Because you're walking around like a zombie in their world, and you can't even see it because everybody's in a dead sleep. They're a bunch of zombies, and you don't even know what's going on, but I do. You see the locust coming out from...
Now he is beginning to communicate with the unconscious mind.
What does that have in common with the Vatican? I'll tell you what it's got in common. The Virgin, and it's got a guy in a slave collar that turns into a locust from the pit. And the largest altar in the world just happens to be a vagina and a penis, which is a dead sheep, and a bunch of semen that a bug's harvesting.
This is where the actual message, the moral of the story, for the unconscious mind is deposited.
You got led astray, and you were, because you got caught in this insurrection, you got brought here, and you are birthed into a human host body, and if you don't get converted by the time you die, you go to the pit and you're food for them, and then all that stuff gets burned root and branch and gets tossed into the lake of fire. So that's your future, and I'm trying to warn you. And if anyone thinks you can argue with this data, you're insane. Just being straightforward. You are. You're insane. You're delusional. I just proved it using t-shirts and using available data. I can do this all day long, folks. Do you understand how obvious this is? Once you can see their world, you're not going to unsee their world.
He is keeping the conscious mind distracted by using graphic images as a diversion technique.
You get it? There you go. See? The way into their little world was they needed some bait to open the dimension into their little world of the other side. And that's how they did it. That's how they opened the dimension. That's why the word womb in the Matrix, and if you don't believe me, I'll just prove it real quick. In the Bible, the word womb is matrix, and I'll prove it. This is a call of Jeremiah. And the word of the Lord came to me, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth from the womb.
Repetition is another hypnosis technique, as you will see here.
Does it say matrix? It sure does, doesn't it? Does it say matrix? It sure does, doesn't it? See what I mean? I mean, you can't argue with the scriptural backup that the Lord gave me. He gave me the unrolled scroll. The scroll is the Bible. He gave me the unrolled scroll. You want to unroll a scroll? Right side up and upside down. That's why it's so easy for me to show you what the Word of God means. Jesus said, your own scriptures say you are God's. You can't argue with that. Look, read it. Just read it for yourself. Read it. Read it. Just read it for yourself. Let's see. Here we go. John. Anyone that wants to argue with you that says you're wrong, then they're calling Jesus a liar no matter what.
This demonstrates how a Bible-believing professing Christian can come to agree with Jonathan Kleck and change their thoughts on a matter. The last 4 minutes are an insidious example of the hypnotic artistry of Jonathan Kleck. He's been doing this for a very, very long time. His current catalog of videos numbers near 2,000. Most between 1 and 2 hours long. Jonathan Kleck uses these techniques to get those who watch his videos to believe and follow his false doctrine. He is able to perform sleight of hand in doctrine right in front of your very eyes. The point of modern propaganda isn't only to misinform or push an agenda. It is to exhaust your critical thinking, to annihilate truth. A quote by Garry Kasparov. We are working together to collate volumes of data into clear and brief videos that may be shared and easily understood. Jonathan Kleck is deceived and in turn is deceiving many. Scripture is our sword. Sharpen it. Be as wise as serpents and harmless as doves.